In this video, I'll show three examples of determining differential y. And then in the next several videos, we'll take a look at applications of differentials. Determining differential y is a fairly straightforward process. We already know that dy dx is equal to f prime of x. So if we write this equation in differential form, we would have dy equals f prime of x times dx. Dy is differential y, and dx is differential x. So to determine differential y, we'll find the derivative of the given function and then multiply by dx. Differential y measures the change in y along the tangent line. And one of the reasons differentials are helpful is we can use differentials to approximate the change in y of a function. Delta y represents the change in y of a function, and it is approximately equal to f prime of x times dx, or differential y. And we'll come back to this idea in the next video. But right now we want to get some practice determining differential y. So for all these examples, differential y is going to be equal to f prime of x times dx. So the first step on all these problems will be to determine the derivative of the given function, and then we'll write out differential y. So for number one, f prime of x is going to be equal to 15x squared minus 14x plus 4. Which means that differential y is going to be equal to the quantity 15x squared minus 14x plus 4 times dx. So as you can see, it's a fairly straightforward process. Now in number two, we will have to apply the chain rule. Our inner function is 2x plus 5, so we'll let that equal u, and we can think of this as u to the 1/3. So to determine f prime of x of u to the 1/3, we'll have 1/3 times u to the 1/3 minus 1, that's negative 2/3, and u is 2x plus 5, times u prime, which would be 2, which means differential y is going to be equal to this derivative. Let's write this as 2 in the numerator. Our denominator is going to be 3. We'll move this down to the denominator, so we'll have the quantity 2x plus 5 to the 2/3. Times dx. And this last example is fairly similar to number two. We have a composite function, so this will be u. So we can think of this as u to the 2/5. So we'll start by determining f prime of x. That'll be 2/5 times u to the 2/5 minus 1, that's negative 3/5. And u is 3x to the 4th. Minus 2 times u prime, which would be 12x to the 3rd. Now that we have the derivative, we can determine differential y. Let's rewrite this as 24x cubed in the numerator. The denominator is going to be 5 times the quantity 3x to the 4th minus 2 to the 3/5 power times differential x or dx. And that's going to do it for this video.